Given f of x equals the square root of x, if g of x is f of x shifted down 2 units and right 3 units, we want to write a formula for g of x. So if g of x is a transformation of f of x, we can write g of x in this form here, where the values of a, b, c, and d affect the graph of f of x. But for this example, since we only have a shift down and a shift right, we only have to be concerned about the value of c and the value of d. So g of x is going to be in the form of g of x equals f of the quantity x plus c plus d, where the value of c shifts the graph left or right, and the value of d shifts the graph up or down. Let's look at an animation to get a feel for how this works. Here's our parent function, or the function given, f of x equals the square root of x. We first want to shift the graph down 2 units, so we'll change the value of d and see how it affects the graph. Notice if d is positive, the graph is shifted up d units. So we have plus some constant outside the square root. And if d is negative, or we have the square root of x minus a value, notice how it's shifted down d units. So we'll have to have a minus 2 outside the square root. So our d is going to be negative or less than 0. So instead of writing plus negative 2, we just write minus 2. And now we'll change the value of c to see how it affects the graph.
Notice if c is positive, or we have x plus c underneath the square root, the graph is actually shifted left c units.
This may be the opposite of what you might think. So because we want a shift of right 3 units, we're actually going to have a negative value of c, or x minus a constant. So in this case, for 3 units right, we'll have x minus 3 underneath the square root. So it would look like this. This is our function g of x that we're looking for. Let's go ahead and write this down, and then we'll summarize what we found. So g of x is equal to the square root of the quantity x minus 3 minus 2, where this minus 2 shifted the graph down 2 units, and the minus 3 underneath the square root here shifted the graph right 3 units. So this is our formula for g of x, but if we want to, we could also express g of x in terms of f of x. Again, if f of x equals the square root of x, then g of x would have to be equal to, we want x minus 3 underneath the square root, that would be f of x minus 3, and then for the minus 2 outside the square root, we have to subtract 2 from f of the quantity x minus 3. So this is the formula this question is asking for. But if you were asked to express g of x in terms of f of x, we would give this. And just in case you need some notes on this, again, if the shift is left or right, then if c is negative or less than 0, the graph is shifted right c units. So we'd have f of the quantity x minus c. And if c is greater than 0 or positive, the graph is shifted left c units, so we'd have f of the quantity x plus c. And then for a shift up or down, if d is negative or less than 0, the graph is shifted down d units, so we'd have f of x minus d. And if d is positive or greater than 0, the graph is shifted up d units, so we'd have f of x plus d. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.